Soil is one of our most precious natural resources. It's the foundation of our whole ecosystem. It is the basis of all plant growth, providing us food, clothing, and other materials. Soil filters water, decomposes waste, stores heat, and exchanges gases. Soil is the core of civilization and is used in construction, medicine, and art. It holds the geologic, climatic, biological, and cultural records of the Earth. Only 10 to 12% of the Earth's surface is available to grow food, fiber, and fuel. It's our responsibility to maintain a delicate balance, maximizing food, fiber, and fuel production without diminishing the soil resource. The U.S. Midwest is one of the Earth's most fertile regions. How do we continue to maximize the land's output without diminishing the soil's natural capacity? Poor soil management can wipe out in decades what the Earth took hundreds, even thousands of years to create. Even under favorable conditions, soil formation is a very slow process. It takes thousands of years for rock to develop into soil, and hundreds of years for rich organic layers to build up. Soil is made up of air, water, mineral particles, organic matter, and organisms. Half the volume of soil is pore space, filled equally with both water and air. Most of the solid portion of soil is mineral particles. Even though organic matter makes up less than 10% of soil volume, it binds soil particles together, stores nutrients, and feeds soil organisms. Organic matter is created by tiny living organisms that decompose dead plants and animals, creating the nutrients needed for new plants to grow. Roots and tunneling creatures turn the soil around and mix it. Without these organisms and activities, plants could not grow. For generations, farmers have turned over the rich black soil. Plowed fields may look and smell great, but turning fields black by plowing under plant residues can turn the skies black through wind erosion and water brown from water erosion. When topsoil is lost, less fertile soil is left behind. The devastating erosion events of the 1920s and 30s led to the establishment of the U.S. Natural Resource Conservation Service in 1935. Originally called the Soil Conservation Service, this organization created the first soil conservation policy and promoted legislation that allowed for the formation of state conservation services such as the Iowa Division of Soil Conservation and the local soil and water conservation districts. In order to preserve agricultural productivity, conservationists have focused on reducing soil loss and displacement. By the end of the 20th century, concerns about air and water quality became as important as concerns about agricultural productivity. To address these challenges and maintain the land's productive potential, we must go beyond erosion control and manage for soil quality. How soil functions on farms, lawns, parks, or forests, not just in buffers or waterways, affects erosion rates, agricultural productivity, air quality, and water quality. Organic matter enhances water and nutrient holding capacity and improves soil structure. Managing soil to increase organic matter can enhance productivity and quality, reducing the severity and costs of natural phenomena such as drought, flood, and disease. In addition, increasing levels of organic matter can increase soil carbon and carbon sequestration or storage and can reduce atmospheric carbon dioxide levels that contribute to climate change. Keeping soil in place is only the beginning of soil conservation. To function well, soil must hold nitrogen, phosphorus, and pesticides in place and keep them out of surface water. Soil must deliver nutrients and water to plants as they need them. Healthy soil can minimize the effects of floods and droughts. Organic matter helps soil perform all these functions. Creating a culture of conservation means accounting for and enhancing soil quality, not just managing land for tolerable soil loss. Think about how these practices control soil erosion while enhancing soil's organic matter. Lengthen crop rotations by adding high residue crops that also increase diversity. Crop health and vigor increase when soil biological activity and diversity increase. Use cover crops when possible. Cover crops can fix nitrogen from the air or capture excess nutrients from the soil in addition to minimizing erosion. Reduce tillage. The best erosion control for Midwest cropland is to use continuous no-till. Other conservation tillage systems aren't as effective. Rotate livestock among pastures to maintain ground cover and protect the soil. This also will ensure the health and productivity of grazing lands. Use mulch anywhere that you have bare soil in your yard or garden. It conserves soil and water. Soil is a living thing that will thrive if properly fed and cared for, whether it is part of a city park, a backyard, or a farmer's field.